extremely happy to be and honored, actually, to be participating as a trainer with Barnett in this most important topic that has become a highly relevant issue in the world of oncology clinical trials, particularly in the last decade, mainly because we've learned so much more and we continue to develop therapies for which our patients and our tumor burden respond quite uniquely. So hence, we needed better options to be able to measure the response. Just to tell you a little bit about myself, by my baseline education, I'm a nurse and have been really operating from the vantage point of an early career in critical care, moving on to clinical research over about the last 27 years. More than a third of my career has been spent in diseases of oncologic focus and immunology. It's a great area of interest for me, and I have spanned many roles throughout clinical research to include being early on a study coordinator and then moving into clinical trials administrator, research manager type roles, as well as then evolving in the last about 5 to 7 years into industry at the level of project manager and clinical research associate. So I've certainly both conducted and then audited and monitored clinical trials in oncology. My main focus in solid tumor activity has really largely been in glioblastoma, which does not look at RECIST criteria quite as much, and then on into ovarian and some breast. So that is what I bring to the table. I'm happy to try to address any questions that come up, even if it's in another area. If I can't answer your question specifically, then certainly we have many subject matter experts to draw from if it's any unique questions that need a bit more examination. I am not the oracle of all wisdom and knowledge, but I certainly want this to be an enriching, baseline-focused experience on the use of RECIST criteria and the importance of it. And I always learn from the participants in the course as well. So, welcome again to Barnett's web seminar on RECIST criteria. It's a disease response assessment tool that was developed for clinical trials of solid tumor oncology agents. So again, today our focus is going to be on solid tumor rather than other types of oncologic or hematologic diagnosis. And RECIST particularly stands for Response Evaluation Criteria in Solid Tumors, taken from the NCI dictionary. We welcome everyone's participation at any level. As Barb discussed, please use, in order to maximize the value of today's web seminar, then please feel free to interrupt me at any time you have a question or comment. We do allow for enough time to do that, and you can do that by either, as she noted, using the raised hand button if you have a question, or chat your question to all the participants, persistently monitoring the area where the chat function is. There will also be opportunities during our time together where I will do knowledge checks for true or false or multiple choice questions and use the web response buttons for that. So let's look at what our objectives are actually today for the course. The first thing we're going to try to do, obviously, because there's been a modified RECIST version, is to differentiate between RECIST versions 1.0 and 1.1. We're going to describe the components of RECIST or tumor data and correctly calculate disease response, try to identify and predict common trends with tumor data, and then use a working knowledge of common trends to help us develop case report forms for oncology trials. That's important because regardless of what you are doing across research teams, whether you're a project manager, a medical monitor, a CRA investigator, or site staff, it's critically important for you to understand and consistently apply these criteria. We know through experience that failure to do so can put the study objectives in jeopardy. And as far as I'm concerned, across the continuum of my career, for me, that means data integrity, and in my opinion, further, ultimately, patient safety. So these are critically important criteria in the way we operate. Just to drive the point home, RESIS is an acronym, again, that stands for Response Evaluation Criteria in Solid Tumors. It's a standard way to measure how well a cancer patient is actually responding to our treatments. It was developed through an international collaboration. Some of you may already know that. And the NCI defines RESIS criteria as a voluntary international standard rather than their own NCI standard. They are based on a simplification of former methods by the World Health Organization and ECOG, and specifically they are talking about measurable disease and the presence, for example, of at least one measurable lesion. So they're a standard way to measure how well a cancer patient responds to treatment, essentially based on whether the tumor shrinks, it stays the same, or it gets bigger when we talk about response evaluation criteria.